You know, today I really don't have a whole lot more than just good news. We've got some submarkets that have seen some increase in vacancy, but we've got others, but are still healthy. But we've seen some other markets that have got record low vacancy, the lowest vacancy we've seen since we've been doing the survey. And a lot of that is driven by 11 million square feet of positive absorption, positive leasing, 11 million square feet. And you got to think about that, how that affects not only our profession, but the region. You've got companies that are growing, they're hiring employees, they're buying computer equipment, they're buying IT equipment. You've got real estate professionals involved with the transactions. You've got architects and engineers involved. You got lawyers involved with the lease paperwork. You've got general contractors that are fitting up the space. So it's got a dramatic impact, again, on this region. And in addition to that, the 11 million square feet means there's 7.5 million square feet of new construction as we enter 2020. That's coming off 4.5 million square feet that we built last year. If there's anything good that's said about real estate communities or regions, this area, we are always at the top. Take a look at Site Selection magazine. I mean, this magazine is well read by a lot of real estate professionals. We're number four business activity. Forbes magazine, we get great accolades here. Best states for business in 2019. I mean, we're at the top of the list. Emerging trends in real estate. Look at this. Top markets for real estate investors in 2020. Around the country, if you're going to invest in real estate, the number two location behind Austin, they point at three things: low taxes, a diverse economy, and what we all know, quality of life. And then Forbes also. Best places for business and careers. Number three is Raleigh, 17 is Durham. But what's driving this economy, and we all know, is job growth. I mean, look at 2010, we had negative job growth. But since then have been averaging 25,000 new jobs each year. Early estimates for 2019, another 25,000 jobs. Forecast for 2020, 22,000 jobs, a little bit of a downtick for 2021, 18,000 new jobs. Now, I will mention there, as I look at past data and I look at these early forecasts 2 years out, we've been beating those for the last 5 years. People want to be here, 10.6 million people, the state of North Carolina, as we finish up 2020, 2.3 million people in our CSA of 11 counties. All right, I want to give you a brief overview of these product categories. If you need specific information on a geographic area, I've got a lot of graphs, a lot of information, and you can dig into that in our website. But I'll start in the multi-purpose category. Now, this is warehouse space, warehouse flex space. It's got a component of office space in it. And it's clearly, you can see the story here. We end the year with record low vacancy at 7%. In 2010, you can see we were as much as 17%. The middle red line, what you're seeing there, is what we determine is a healthy market. So you see in the multi-purpose category, you've got single-digit vacancy below the healthy line market. This is a landlord's market as we move into 2020. One very active market in the multi-purpose category is the Research Triangle Park. Take a look at that in green. In 2017, on the right-hand side of your screen, we were as much as 14% vacancy in RTP, but we've had two really good years of declining vacancy to 10% vacancy in the Research Triangle Park, healthy vacancy there, and that's driven by 1.9 million square feet of positive absorption there. Ed Brown, an industrial specialist, he's going to tell you about another really good market.
The Garner and Southeast submarkets for Flex and Warehouse did really well in 2019. We had over 1 million square feet of the two products absorbed. That brought our collective vacancy for Flex and Warehouse down to 5.7%. As a result of all that activity, we had 500,000 square feet of spec space developed. We're here in Garner today at NYR's new 675,000 square foot industrial park. The building here to my right is a 150,000 square foot Class A warehouse that will be delivered in April. The demand for these two submarkets come from building supply companies, e-commerce companies, last mile, last touch companies, and just general commodity distribution companies providing goods to the growing population. The development growth will continue in these two submarkets for the near future. And one of the reasons is there's just not any remaining land available out by the airport. And the land that is available is too expensive to make flex and industrial work. Also, the growing population will bode well for these two submarkets, as will the continued expansion of I-540. So Garner and Southeast submarkets of Flex and Warehouse are positioned to do really well in 2020 and into the future.
Man, he's the best. Thank you, Ed. In all of this low vacancy and this new construction in the multipurpose category is being driven by overall absorption. On the right-hand side of your screen, 4% of the entire market, record absorption, 6 million square feet was absorbed, 4 million square feet the previous year, and then 1.3 million square feet the 2 years prior. And obviously that results in a lot of new construction. There's 3.3 million square feet underway in the multipurpose category, coming off about 2 million square feet that was built last year. In the shopping center market, the story here is for the first time in 4 years, vacancy on the right-hand side of your screen actually dropped to 3%. Healthy vacancy, as you're seeing there with the red line, is about 4%. Because in the shopping center market, the retail market, so much of the new construction is already pre-leased, so we really don't get these, you know, vacancy out of whack too much, unless, of course, which we've seen, a big box vacates or a big shopping center vacates. But that's the only, other than that, you usually see a healthy 3 or 4% vacancy in the shopping center market. Joaquin Canals is our retail specialist. He's going to tell you about a couple of specific markets.
North Raleigh experienced the most retail growth of any submarket, with just over 500,000 square feet leased in 2019. This was primarily at Midtown East, with the new Wegmans and other smaller retail spaces to include the completion of a new Sprouts and Lidl. This activity resulted in a very low 2.5% vacancy for the North Raleigh submarket. The Cary Apex market is experiencing the most new construction heading into 2020. Projects to include Wegmans and other retail spaces at Twin Lakes on Davis Drive and Green Level Market contributed to the 628,000 square feet now underway. It should be noted that just about all major retail development is supermarket driven. I'm standing in front of the new 55,000 square foot Publix at Smoky Hollow in downtown Raleigh, which is being developed by Williams Realty and Kane Development. This is the first full service grocer to enter the submarket. The additional story in downtown Raleigh is the code requirements for multifamily and office developers to build a required amount of street level retail in their projects. This has resulted in over 60,000 square feet of available retail space in downtown and the Glenwood South Corridor. Will there be a demand for 60,000 square feet of retail in downtown? Time will tell. In 2020, retailers and retail developers will continue to struggle with the ever-changing landscape of store closings, development hurdles, and the unpredictable customer.
Thank you, Joaquin. Overall absorption in the shopping center market, you can see the right-hand side of your screen, really none in 2018, 1% in 2019, 753,000 square feet. And what that results in, again, 963,000 square feet under construction in the shopping center category, 580,000 square feet that was built last year. Okay, let's talk about the office market a little bit. When you look at the office market, again, you can see another trend here. Look at 17% vacancy in 2010. Vacancy here has dropped for the third year in a row to single digits in 2019. Again, record low absorption in the overall vacancy in 8% vacancy in the overall office market. You can see the red line is the health, indicates what's a healthy market, 11, 12%. So the 8% vacancy, tenants are slowly gathering that it is now a landlord's market. A couple of markets to take a look at. Looking at blue at the top of your screen. This is the Research Triangle Park market. In 2010, this market had as much as 22% vacancy. Now, the previous 10 years prior to that, vacancy in the Research Triangle Park market was averaging 22 to 25%. We've seen a nice decline in this market, finishing the year at 13%, just a tad above the healthy market line. And then take a look at the bottom of your screen in gold. This is downtown Durham. Really low vacancy over the last 9 years. 2015, 2016, as much as 4%. Very minimal vacancy in this market. But what I'll point out is the last 4 years, vacancy has gone up in downtown Durham, finishes the year at 11%, still healthy, but we need some really nice leasing in downtown Durham so that 2020 continues to be a healthy market there. Ryan Gaylord and Robin Anders are going to tell you about another very active market.
Ryan and I are standing at North Chase at Midtown at 6601 Six Forks Road, a great example of a mid-80s redevelopment turnaround success story. North Chase is in the heart of suburban Raleigh, which experienced the most office absorption of any submarket. With an inventory of approximately 37 million square feet of office space, suburban Raleigh had 3.5% absorption. That's 1.3 million square feet, resulting in a drop in vacancy to 6%, its lowest point in 20 years. As expected, this low vacancy led to a record year of new construction starts, totaling 900,000 square feet as we enter 2020.
A few of the new construction starts in this submarket include North Hills Tower 4, now the Advance Auto Park Tower with their 200,000 square foot pre-lease, Highwoods Properties Glen Lake 7, Crabtree Terrace on Glenwood Avenue, and Grub Properties 3800 Glenwood. All these projects have strong leasing activity, which will result in another year of low office vacancy for the suburban Raleigh submarket.
Great job. Look what's driving this construction. The right-hand side of your screen. Again, 5% absorption, record absorption in the overall office market, 4.3 million square feet. On the left-hand side of your screen, I mean, who could imagine? Well, I could imagine because I was there. I was living it. 2010, we had negative absorption. We had more tenants moving out than moving in, but we obviously end 2019 with 5%. And that results in a lot of new construction. 3.1 million square feet in the overall office market as we head into 2020. We built 2.3 million square feet the previous year. Now look on the left-hand side of your screen. You remember I said we had negative absorption in 2010. 2011, 12, 13, my friends at Bobbitt were saying back then, Jimmy, you gotta talk about new construction. And I'm like, big fella, we don't have any new construction. But we've made a nice recovery again. 5 million square feet that'll be built over the last couple of years. Every submarket in the office category has new construction, and suburban Raleigh is leading the way at 29%. In the hotel and hospitality market, you see the story here. Average daily rate, look at that incline since 2010, at $110 a night. And clearly the reason why average occupancy is at 75%. Hotels, there's 8 hotels under construction in Wake County, 1 in Durham County, with more projected by the end of the year. All right, let's talk about the residential markets. The apartment market. Pretty clear what's happening here. 2009, we had as much as 10% vacancy. We've had a really nice decline. We finished the year in the apartment market at 4.9% vacancy, record low. We haven't seen this low of a vacancy since we've been doing the survey. But the reason being is, even in the face of all the new construction, we got good absorption. I mean, look in 2019, another 3,200 units absorbed in the apartment market. Yep, there's some new construction, right-hand side of your screen, 7,600 units. that are underway, 3,500 units proposed in 2020. But again, we have no reason to believe that we're not going to get the continued absorption that we get, another 3,000 units. The apartment market's going to be fine. We'll stay at 5%. How about single-family homes? Now, this is in Wake County. The top line shows sales. And what you're seeing here is another strong year of 25,000 new sales, new and pre-owned homes. But if you'll notice, it's the first time in 7 years that it has actually declined. Again, still a really big year, but it actually has declined. And then at the bottom of your screen, you'll see inventory. Still very low inventory, but for the first time in 7 years, inventory actually ended the year with an increase.